To the people of Sumeru, who are accustomed to receiving concrete information from the Akasha, the arts are an abstract and intangible concept. What constitutes good art? Is there a way to quantify its value? These questions leave even the academia's most esteemed scholars at a loss. But to Nilu, art is the simplest and purest thing in the world. There is no barrier to entry, and everyone can appreciate its beauty.
Where are we dancing today?
Though Nilu's dancing may appear delicate, there is measured strength behind every step. Nilu integrates swordplay with agile footwork as she waltzes with the water to the aid of her allies. Dancing requires not only grace, but physical endurance as well. That is why Nilu pays particular attention to her dietary intake. When Nilu achieves perfect cooking on dishes with adventure-related effects, she has a certain chance to double the product. Nilu's normal attack can combo up to 3 strikes, dealing physical damage to enemies. When using her charged attack, Nilu consumes a certain amount of stamina to unleash a twirling strike, dealing physical damage. When she uses her elemental skill, Nilu enters the pirouette state, dealing hydro damage to nearby enemies based on her max HP. While in the pirouette state, using Nilu's normal attack or elemental skill triggers her sword dance stance, or whirling step stance, respectively, while damage she deals is converted to hydro damage that cannot be overridden and is treated as elemental skill damage. While the pirouette state is active, Nilu's third stance will end this state and trigger a different effect depending on the stance. If Nilu's final stance is Sword Dance, she unleashes a luminous illusion that inflicts hydro damage to enemies it hits, while also gaining the Lunar Prayer effect. While Lunar Prayer is active, Nilu's normal attack is converted to a Sword Dance, and her final hit will unleash a luminous illusion. If Nilu's final stance is Whirling Steps, she unleashes a Whirling Water Wheel that deals AoE hydro damage. Also, a Tranquility Aura is created that follows your active character and applies the wet status to enemies in range. Nilu cannot perform charged attacks while the Pirouette or Lunar Prayer status is active. Leaving the battlefield will remove the status. After unlocking the talent Court of Dancing Petals, if the party consists exclusively of Dendro and Hydro characters, including at least one of each, the third stance of Nilu's elemental skill, when executed, will confer the Golden Chalice's bounty effect on all nearby characters for a limited time. When a character under the effects of Golden Chalice's bounty is hit by a Dendro attack, the elemental mastery of all nearby characters is increased for a certain time. Additionally, triggering a Bloom reaction will produce a Bountiful Core instead of a Dendro Core. The Bountiful Core's attack is treated as a post-Bloom Dendro Core attack, but it bursts more quickly and has a larger AoE than the Dendro Core. Bountiful Cores cannot trigger Hyper Bloom or Burgeon reactions, and they share the same field limit as Dendro Cores. Nilu's dancing style is the stuff of dreams, captivating her audience's hearts and bolstering their spirits. After unlocking the talent Dreamy Dance of Eons, Bountiful Cores triggered due to Golden Chalice's bounty deal increased damage based on how much of Nilu's max HP exceeds a given value. Bountiful Core damage can only be increased in this manner by up to a certain amount.
Is for you.
Nilu's elemental burst begins a dance of faraway dreams and melodic springs that causes a lotus of distant waters to bloom, dealing AoE hydro damage based on Nilu's max HP. Enemies hit by the elemental burst will sustain the lingering eon effect, which deals hydro damage after a short delay. To Nilu, there is little difference between battle and dance, since both can be used to resolve one's troubles. Most of Nilu's combat is centered around her elemental skill. She freely dances between her two stances, with Sword Dance allowing her to continuously inflict hydro damage via Lunar Prayer, and Whirling Steps setting the stage for follow-up elemental reactions through the persistent Tranquility Aura effect. With the right party composition, Nilou's third stance during the performance of her elemental skill grants the Golden Chalice's Bounty effect to her teammates. Triggering the Bloom reaction while this effect is active spawns special Bountiful Cores that deal greater damage to enemies. When her elemental energy is full, Nilou can use her elemental burst to begin a dance of faraway dreams, dealing AoE hydro damage and applying the Lingering Aeon effect to any enemies hit. The Lingering Aeon follows up with a further attack after a short delay, ushering in the curtain call of Nilou's spectacular performance. I must stress that I am a warrior and in no way versed in the disciplines of song and dance. If anyone was expecting to hear my philosophical musings on these topics, I'm sorry to disappoint. But while I am no connoisseur, even I find myself moved once in a while by the sight of an extraordinary performance. Even for the Nation of Wisdom, citing the pursuit of rationality as a justification for refusing to acknowledge the comfort that an audience can find in the arts is sheer arrogance. When groups clash, or human ideals conflict with the rules of the world around them, disputes of this nature most often arise from the inability to tolerate the existence of that which is different from oneself.